In this video, I will show you the operation of diode and gate. We can perform our logical AND operation and OR operation using simple diode logic. See here, I have AND gate here, and this AND gate has two inputs, V1 and V2, and I am taking the output from this terminal. The operation of this AND gate is like, if we have at least one zero at the input side, our output voltage will be zero. See here, I have an AND gate here. This AND gate has two logical inputs, V1 and V2, and I am taking the output across this terminal. The operation of this AND gate is such that if I have at least one zero at any of these two terminals, our output logic will be equal to 0. Therefore, it is the truth table of this AND gate. 00, our output voltage will be 0. 01, our output voltage will be 0. 10, in case of logic 10, our output voltage will be 0. But in case of, if both of these inputs are at logic 1, our output will be at logic 1 in case of our AND gate. See, this is our diode AND gate. Here we are using two diodes, D1 and D2. Let's say these diodes are made of silicon. Therefore, if in the input, if I apply any voltage greater than 0.7 volt, that will be treated as logic 1 in case of this diode AND gate. For convenience, let's say I will apply plus 5 volt as logic 1. If our input becomes less than 0.7 volt, I will get our logic 0. And for convenience, for logic 0, I will apply 0 volt. For logic 1, I will apply 5 volt. That means I will connect a 5 volt DC source across this terminal to ground, or this terminal to ground. And when I am talking about logic 0, that means this terminal is directly connected to ground, or this terminal is directly connected to ground. Now let me talk about the first case, when both of the inputs are at logic 0. V1 will be at logic 0 and V2 will be at logic 0. In that case, I have to show that our output will be at logic 0. See, when V1 is at logic 0, that means this terminal is connected to the ground terminal. When V2 is at logic 0, that means this terminal is connected to ground terminal. After connecting the input terminals with ground terminal, you will see the positive terminal of this VCC is connected with the P side of the diode D1. The positive terminal of this VCC is connected with the P side of the diode D2. The negative terminal of this VCC is connected with the ground terminal. Therefore, the negative terminal of this VCC will be connected with the N side of the diodes D1 and D2. Therefore, you will see both of the diode D1 and D2 will be in forward bias. So when a diode is in forward bias, if I consider the diodes as an ideal diode, I can replace them with a short circuit. So after replacing the diodes D1 and D2 with short circuit, you will see the voltage between this terminal to this ground terminal, or the voltage between this terminal to ground terminal, will be equal to 0. And we are taking the output across this terminal to ground terminal. So for the inputs 00, our output will be equal to 0 volt, or it will indicate the logic 0, because this is a total short circuit, and across a short circuit I will get a voltage drop equal to 0 volt. Now let me talk about the second case. V1 will be at logic 0. That means this input 1 terminal is connected to ground terminal, and V2 will be at logic 1. That means I will apply a 5 volt voltage across this terminal to ground terminal. So our V2 will be equal to plus 5 volt. When I will apply a plus 5 volt across this terminal to ground terminal, you will see the positive terminal of this 5 volt will be connected with the N side of the diode D2, and the negative terminal will be connected with the P side of the diode D2. That means our diode D2 will be in reverse bias. So when a diode is in reverse bias, I can replace it with an open circuit. I will replace the diode with open circuit. That means I can remove this entire branch from our logic network, and this terminal will connect to ground terminal. So when this input one terminal is connected to ground terminal, you will see the positive terminal of this VCC will be connected with the P side of the diode, and the negative terminal of this VCC, as that is connected to ground terminal, therefore the negative terminal of this VCC will be connected to the N side of the D1, N side of the diode D1. Therefore I can say our diode D1 will be in forward bias. So when a diode is in forward bias, I can replace that with a short circuit. After replacing the diode D1 with a short circuit, you will see I am taking the output across this terminal, and this will indicate the same terminal, and this terminal will indicate the same terminal. I am taking the output across this terminal to ground terminal, which will be equal to 0 volt, because with respect to these two terminals, you will see I will have a total short path connected across this output to ground terminal. Therefore our output will be equal to 0 volt. Therefore I can say our output will be at logic 0. Consider the third case, when V1 will be at logic 1 and V2 will be at logic 0. V1 will be at logic 1, that means I will apply plus 5 volt across this terminal to ground terminal. You will see the positive terminal of this 5 volt will be connected with the inside of the diode D1, and the negative terminal will be connected with the P side of the diode D1. So diode D1 will be in reverse bias. So when a diode is in reverse bias, I can replace that with an open circuit. I can replace the diode D1 with an open circuit. That means I can remove the entire branch that is containing the diode D1 with an open circuit. Our V2 will be at logic 0. That means this terminal will be connected to ground terminal. When this terminal will be connected to ground terminal, the voltage between these two terminals will be equal to 0 volt. So our V2 will be at logic 0. Now you will see the positive terminal of this VCC will be connected with the P side of the diode D2, and the negative terminal will be connected with the N side of the diode D2. So our diode D2 will be in forward bias. So when the diode D2 will be in forward bias, I can replace that with a short circuit if I consider that as an ideal diode. If I replace the diode D2 with a short circuit, due to the short circuit, the voltage difference between this terminal to ground terminal will be equal to 0 volt. And you will see I will take the output across a total short circuit. So our output voltage will be equal to 0 volt. So for input 1, 0, our output will be at logic 0. Now consider the last case, when V1 will be at logic 1 and V2 will be at logic 1. V1 will be at logic 1, that means I will apply plus 5 volt between this terminal to ground terminal, plus 5 volt between input 2 terminal to ground terminal. You will see the positive terminal of the 5 volt will be connected with the N side of the diode D1, and the positive terminal of this 5 volt will be connected with the N side of the diode D2, and the negative terminal will be connected with the P side. So I can say our diode D1 and D2 will be in reverse bias. So when two diodes are in reverse bias, I can replace them with an open circuit. If I replace the diode with an open circuit, you will see the current through this load resistor IL will be equal to 0, because this output to ground terminal is a total open circuit. Therefore IL RL drop will be equal to 0. That means I will see this plus VCC will be appeared across this terminal to ground terminal. So our VO will be equal to VCC. Usually the value of this VCC is around plus 5 volt. Therefore our output will be at logic 1. That's it. Thank you.